Good morning, everyone. I'm Cynthia Sharp with Synchronicity Biofeedback and Healing Energy Work. And thank you for joining me this morning. I had some interesting conversations yesterday with a couple moms with additional needs children. And one has an older son, and one has a son close to my son's age. And what was so remarkable was the message that I was hearing from these two mothers, that I need not restrict my own story of what is happening and unfolding in my life, that I need to share it so that I can create hope and inspiration for additional needs parents who during this time have maybe felt as though there's a certain reality and that's the only reality that there is. So what do I mean by that? So obviously we're in this time of COVID, right? And COVID has meant a lot of restrictions as far as socialization. I recently read this week an article about additional needs parents being the hardest hit as far as not having services, as far as children having some major behavioral issues, and a ton of regression. And not being able to get the support, and the families not getting the support that they need. These two moms who I spoke with yesterday were very much enjoying what I was saying about the reality of what has happened in our lives, and very encouraging and insistent that I share this so that other additional needs families can benefit. So here I go. Forgive me, because this makes me vulnerable. It makes me, I want to make sure that additional needs families don't feel as if I am boasting, but I want to make sure that you understand that I'm trying to share a different reality. And the reality is that not all children go through regression. That not all children, because they're with additional needs, have experienced the major behavioral outbursts that so many are sharing right now, and how difficult it is. I will be honest, the very beginning of COVID, we were anticipating that it was going to be difficult. We didn't know how it was going to work for our son. We didn't know how it was going to work for us. And we were comfortably blessed with the capability of our son being able to go ahead and fluidly transition into online schooling. We noticed certain behaviors because of too much technology, that blue light, that sitting in front of a screen is just not really for our son. So we had to make accommodations. That wasn't like a big deal. We managed, we worked through it. It was fluid. And everyone was quite surprised at like how well behaved he was. So once school ended, it was even more impressive because he really, really came into center, really came into a sense of calm. And we really tried to have life be as much normal as usual, even though we're pretty much at home all the time. So what I noticed that was impressive of what has happened during this time, things that I had been told would not happen with a child with Down syndrome, that they would possibly teach themselves how to do something. And that has been the most amazing part. So my son taught himself how to swim backwards. Now, not the whole backstroke, but truly just a very fluid stroke where he's floating. And it's beautiful to watch. But he's also taught himself how to swim with a kickboard and to propel himself comfortably with the kickboard, where before he was kind of using it inappropriately and not in a bad way. It was just not physically where he needed to actually have it be fluid. Then his reading improved. He picked up a chapter book and actually could read the chapter book. And I actually looked online because I've been curious as to what the reading level is. And interestingly enough, there wasn't like a grade level. But from my teaching experience, it's, I would say it's about a fourth or fifth grade level. And this is a child that a year ago was really, really struggling with reading and reading at age level. So there have been some great strides. Multiplication facts, things that we didn't think would hold and would continue. It has been amazing to watch him want, as he's doing this right now, as I'm doing this live video, he's on his computer and doing what's called fast math through Collier County. It's amazing, and he desires it. He wants to go ahead and learn his math facts. And interestingly enough, we play games. We play like Payday or Monopoly, and we work on those math skills. But the math skills that he's retaining right now are just amazing. So why has this happened? And how can I help you to create that? So let's be real. We only have one child, and one child it is much different than having two or three, because obviously there's different focus. My husband and I have definitely balanced work and time with our son. So my husband works predominantly in the mornings, and then I have clients in the afternoons and or on the weekends. So we're constantly rotating and balancing. We've also worked on, you know, that independence. So one of the things that I have my son do while I'm making lunch is, okay, I need you to go ahead and read. And he takes time now to actually sit down on the couch and read. So I'm trying to prepare him for that independence, and I keep on reiterating that to him so that it's mentally instilled somewhere in him and ingrained that he needs that independence level. And in order to have that, we need to practice that now so that he can have that even greater in the future. And it was amazing. One day it really took a long time for me to go ahead and make lunch because there were so many interruptions. It was 45 minutes of him sitting on the couch. I'm not joking. And this was a child who, wow, to even get like 10 minutes of sitting down and doing that was a task. Now, I'm going to be honest, we have taken advantage of ABA therapy, and that was the initiator. They got that started. They helped. But it was up to us to instill it at home because he was only going to ABA once a week when they started that. So taking the tools of what they were doing and really working alongside really helped us as a family. We really work on those tools of self-soothing. How can we help him self-soothe? And right now, as school is approaching, we're noticing some emotional outbursts, but nowhere where we thought it would be. Nowhere. So yes, we're going to go ahead and work on that. We're going to address it. Obviously, I'm a biofeedback practitioner. I do energy work, but I also need to kind of ascertain, where is it coming from? Is it the apprehension of what school is going to be? Is it that he really is missing family? Is it a mixture, because we deal with some sleep issues, is it a mixture in lack of sleep? Because obviously, sleep is where you restore and where you balance your hormones. And if you're not getting that continuous amount of sleep, it's just going to actually deplete your capability of being emotionally stable. It just is. I feel it when I don't have the sleep and my sleep is interrupted. I feel what I call superhuman, like, and not in like that superwoman kind of way, but really human versus balanced. Like, I feel very vulnerable, very emotional when sleep is continuously disrupted. So taking all of that into consideration and moving forward, where is his mental capacity? Like, this week we made a date for the beach, did a picnic, a breakfast picnic at the beach so that we could avoid people and the populace. And interestingly enough, it was actually kind of busy at the beach where we were, and I want to say we had about 10 people. But, you know, on a rainy day, it was absolutely beautiful. We had gone to that beach and no one was around, so we decided to go ahead and go back and try it. And comparatively, I understand some beaches are much heavier trafficked. This was very fortunate. So we picnicked at the beach and then came home and made a day of it. Went swimming in the pool and just played. So this is going to be the interesting part. How much are you balancing? And during this time of COVID, as a parent, what are you doing to balance yourself so you can provide that for your child? And that has been the negotiation in our home. How do we balance our professional careers and the development of ourselves professionally and on a personal basis and allow that and encourage that for our son? And that really has helped us during this time so that he can succeed, so that I'm amazed that he wants to go ahead and do his math facts all by himself and really study and get faster. That he's good with reading a book or more. I mean, he sat down the other day with just a whole bunch of magazines. We have the National Geographic magazines, kids, and he just loves that. So I'm excited. He'll be getting a new prescription of glasses shortly, where the bifocal lens is going to actually be much more intensified, and so that smaller print is going to be much more easily visible. So there are little things that the cumulative effort impacts, right? Everything builds up and impacts the cumulative effort. What else has happened during this time? The whole teaching himself, right? Being able to say, I've done it. The words of encouragement. We know that as additional needs families, but at this time what I'm hearing is so many additional needs families are feeling depleted because, let's be real, our additional needs kids take a lot of energy. And we need some of that for ourselves. And we're exhausted. This has been going since March. And how do we replenish? So some moms, depending upon where they are, I've heard have gone out for a massage, and this is where they're very, very safe. They're not in the high numbers as we are down in Florida. I have noticed that when we have gone to the beach, when we have gone out into nature, it really, really restores us. I meditate. I get to head a meditation every single week. It restores me then as well. I swim and I play with my son quite a bit. And I'll be honest, last night was a difficult night for us. The last few nights have been a little difficult because of sleep. And I ended up being with my son early this morning. And there I am looking at him like 5 o'clock in the morning and just lying there. And instead of being upset with him, like, why are you up at this time? I was grateful. Grateful that I had the opportunity to say that I have a beautiful child that I get to share this moment with. And it really is our mindset that affects us. And I cannot say that any more strongly. Because yes, there are moments that life impacts us and we are so, so human, right? So vulnerable, and we just need our time. And we just want our time. And how do we balance that? And how do we enjoy our kids at the exact same time? But if we take in that deep breath and recognize where we're at, recognize where they're at, and most importantly, set an intention of where we want to be, I wanted to enjoy my son this morning. I didn't care that he was awake. I was grateful that I had a happy child who was looking at me and smiling. He was grateful to be snuggling with me so that I could snuggle him back and provide the love that we both needed, and to get the love that I needed this morning too, to do this, right? It is beautiful. And I think it's really hard because of where our mindsets are and because of all that we're being inundated with on a political basis of where is our country headed. On a COVID basis, is mask wearing, is it not mask wearing the real option? On the school basis, what is going to happen? What is the reality of sending our children to school? Are they going to be safe? Are they going to be healthy? And then on a professional level and an economic level of how COVID is affecting us all. Because until the numbers go down, we can't really open up for business, right? And until we have this situated, we're just kind of stuck and we're running this hamster wheel. And that hamster wheel is running in our minds. And if we're not careful, we can't step out of it and actually enjoy the rest of what's really happening right here, right now. Taking care of yourself and nurturing yourself. You know, if you've put your child on a special diet, more than likely, I would hope that you've done that for yourself as well, because self-care is bar none absolutely important. That oxygen mask is necessary. And when you do that, and they see that you're doing that for you, you help them realign and know that that's what they need to do for themselves. Not just now, but later. Later in life, they will look back and go, well, I need to do that because I watched my mom, my dad do the same thing. And now it's time for me to go ahead and do that, whether or not they have kids or not. It will be something that has been instilled for them. So, the hope. The hope is that if you want your life to change and you want to see something actually come to a capacity within your life, I can help you, please do not hesitate to reach out to me. It is truly together that we're going to make this change. And if we do not bond together, and if we do not come together as a community to help and support each other, we're doing no one a service. Not our children. Not ourselves, and definitely not society. We are stronger together, and we forget that because we're so involved in our lives and all that our kids have us going through that we forget to reach out and reconnect. So, if there is anything that I can do for you, please do not hesitate to reach out and let me know. And share. Share with anyone that would benefit from this. Because as a community, if we come together and we help one individual, that ripple effect is huge, because then they start affecting another individual. It affects their family, it affects their friends, it affects the community, and it keeps on going. And we make this world a better place for our kids. So I thank you for taking your time to be with me today. And if I may be of assistance, please do not hesitate to reach out to me. Have a great day, and we'll talk next Friday, 10 a.m. Be blessed. I look forward to hearing from you. Bye-bye.